The people are real. The cases are questionable. The rulings are definitely fake. These people have COVID-19 disputes. Both parties have agreed to drop their complaints and have their issues resolved remotely here in Kyla's court. They've submitted their disputes through our online forum for a resolution from Judgy Kyla. And now, here's Judgy Kyla. All arise. Kyla's court is now in session.
Thank you. Be seated. Today, we are going to resolve some disputes that have been submitted to us via Twitter. Kyla's court is always interested in ensuring there are alternative methods of dispute resolution via video, Twitter, email, and other methods during this pandemic. So our first dispute is coming in from Denise Dibbs on Twitter. Denise has got a case involving a dog bite. Denise writes, "My neighbor's dog, off-leash, sticks her face under the fence of another neighbor. The dog in the fenced backyard bites the face of a little unleashed dog whose face is under the fence. The dog suffers loss of teeth and facial injury. Who pays the vet bill?" That's a really good question, Denise, and I'm going to have to reach out to you for further evidence in this case. I need to know whether the dog that's off the leash is in his own yard, and whether this is a shared fence between yards, or whether or not this is a fence that is accessible to the street and the off-leash dog is on the street. So Denise has written back, and she's indicated that the neighbor's dog is in a fenced backyard, but the other's neighbor's dog is off-leash in the back alley. Well, that's very important information, Denise, because when the dog is off-leash, contrary to City of Vancouver bylaws and contrary to leashing rules, that dog is unsupervised and free to roam about. And the owner is responsible, in my opinion, for what happens to the dog while it's not being properly supervised and properly leashed in accordance with the law. It also appears that this dog, the supposed victim dog, is guilty of trespass. I say that because the dog stuck his face under the fence into the backyard of the neighbor's dog, thereby breaching the fence and thereby exposing itself to the risk of being bitten. And I'm very sympathetic to this dog, who Denise has provided a photo of and who is incredibly cute. I'll just show this photo to everybody here. But that's no excuse for bad dog behavior and bad dog maintenance. My ruling is that the neighbor who had the dog off leash is responsible for her own dog's vet bills.
Tune in next week for another episode of Kyla's Court. Kyla's Court is not a real court. All submissions are the express property of Kyla Lee Heavy Industries and Lee Pharmaceuticals, a division of Lee Shipbuilding and Dredging.